Okay, good afternoon, guys. How are you doing today? Ade Oluyinka, good afternoon. Triumph Oguchukwu, good afternoon. How are you doing? It's a pleasure having you here. Yes, indeed. Great. So today is a live market session, live trading session. So of course, we're going to be looking at the market. We're going to dig in and find opportunities in the market. We're going to more or less find how to enter and then to exit trades based on strategy, a simple strategy that is, right? And that strategy, if you want to learn it, you can as well attend the beginner's workshop, right? Where we talk about the likes of price action, support, and resistance. And thank you. I can see Ade Oluyinka said good afternoon, sir, and Triumph to say good afternoon, everyone. So that means that the audio level is good to go from you. I hope it is clear enough, and I hope it is loud enough as well. Right? Do let us know, as we are going to dive fully in a matter of minutes. Right? So of course, what we want to achieve today, the outcome would be clarity. If you are a trader, especially, and you have been struggling for a little while, we want to help you with clarity with respect to how to look at the market from, well, we could say from different angles, because we're all different traders at the end of the day, and we have our different strategies and all. By the end of the day, they must align, right? Okay, thank you, Triumph. You said yes, I can hear you. Thank you for that. Okay, so let's gradually start to steamroll. Let's take it one after the other, right? And obviously, as we said, now the outcome we want for everybody is clarity, right? So you can read the charts like an open book, of course, for consistent profitability at the end of the day. Live market analysis is brought to you by Tentrade. And my name is Tolu Olatunji. I have been trading for a few years. And of course, I have seen my fair share of losses, crashed accounts, and all. Right. At times, I like to tell my story so that people could learn from them. Because as you are here, you're obviously here to learn how to make money the proper way. So we are welcome once again. Kindly do something for us as we proceed. Please ensure to share this link with others so that you could join us. I repeat, ensure to share this link with others so that they can join us for this session today. Right? Okay, so as we dive in fully, also note that when you have questions, feel free to ask the questions and then we will look at the questions together. I repeat, when we have questions, feel free to ask questions and then we can look at them together. If you have any instruments of choice that you would like us to discuss, right? Whether it's Euro, USD, or whatever the case might be, if we do not mention it, then please mention it and then we will look at them together. Awesome. I can see more people are joining us now, which is fantastic, right? So now, for those that are just coming, I hope the audio is still good for you. Just need to do that clarification. And then also, we are recording this, so just in case anybody comes in late. But one thing we also need to note is that one thing we need to note is that this recording will be available on the YouTube channel. So it's always good for you to follow us on YouTube as well, right? Follow us on YouTube. So you're welcome to those that just come in, Okonkwo Kanayo, Olalekan Abdulaziz, Opeyemi Abdulrazak, how are you doing, sir? You are the one who won. When was it? I think that was on Sunday. Yeah, you won the phone call. I gave you a call. So let me know how you are proceeding so that we could discuss further and help everybody else. One thing we want you to know is that Tentrade is here for you. Tentrade wants to help everybody. Tentrade has your interest at heart. So anywhere, let me ask the question now for everybody. Anywhere, anyhow that you feel Tentrade can help you, do let us know and you can type it in the comment section. Okay, thank you, Mr. Okwemi just said, I'm doing good, boss. Thanks for the inspiration. No problem, that's what we do. We need to help ourselves out. By the way, for those that came in much earlier, for those that came in before the 2 p.m., What you were listening to was an audiobook. I repeat, what you're listening to was an audiobook. And the title of the audiobook was The Secrets of the Millionaire Mind. The Secrets of the Millionaire Mind. It's always good to read books. And if you can't read, you can listen to audiobooks. Right? Books will help you and shape your mind. Right? The Secrets of the Millionaire Mind was just talking about, in summary, how to start thinking like a millionaire, how to behave like a millionaire. Before you get there, it's like you're prophesying into your life, right? And when you prophesy, when you do that, it starts to manifest. So we all need to start thinking differently. There's something I tell traders today. Do not tell yourself, I cannot afford it. Never ever say that. Don't say, I can't afford it. Or rather, what you should be saying is, how can I afford it? How can I afford it? And then you start to walk towards that thing. And I hope that makes sense to everybody. Please, guys, as we are still joining, please kindly share this link, right? The link for this training. Kindly share it on your WhatsApp status. Kindly share it on other platforms as well, right? So that they can come and learn a thing or two on how to trade. Right, so I'm just going to drop the link over here so that you could share with those, right, that might be interested. So that's the link. Just tell them to register now with the link that is happening now, 2 p.m. We haven't gone too far. We haven't even looked at charts. We're just doing the regular welcome and introduction as well. So share the link. Let's have more people join us. Let's fill up this house. Let's have about 50 people here. So guys, share the link, share the link, share the link. And then let's have more people join us. Right. And by the way, that was how Mr. Femi Abdulrazak was able to have a phone call from me. I gave him a call on Sunday after we had a session, and that session was the trading headache and prescription webinar that we had on Sunday. Right. So peradventure, if anybody, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but I'm just saying peradventure, if you happen to invite as many people and then you are very active here, then you might as well win something. I might just, you know, as the spirit leads, right? So 10 Trade is here for you. Please also follow us on the YouTube as well. I'll drop the YouTube link if you are not yet following us on that, so that you follow us. And then when this recording is dropped, you can go back and quickly watch it, because this live market analysis session is to discuss the market right now. So there's a matter of urgency, right? So do the needful, follow 10 Trade on social media handles, and then comment on our post and so on, right? So now let's do something without further ado. Let's cross over to the charts. Let's start discussing the charts. Let's start brainstorming on the charts, and let's see what we can make out of the charts so that we could hopefully make some pips, right? And we also have a signals group as well, where I will drop more charts for people to also use and then to learn and also try to make money from. We do that on a weekly basis. A few people drop signals, and then you can also take advantage of them. You can learn from them as well, apart from just using them to trade, right? Okay. So the first trade, or the first chart rather, I haven't taken any trade this week yet, but the first chart that we have right in front of us, as you can see, right, as you can see, is the Euro USD. The Euro USD is arguably the most traded currency pair in the world, right? And I believe some of us are most likely trading it as well, right? So now we're going to look at this based on price action support and resistance. As I said, we are big on price action support and resistance. If you want to learn more on that, you can attend the beginner session. It's going to be happening later today by 6 p.m. Mr. Toby Okunuga will be handling that, so you can attend that and then learn some more from the beginner's perspective. But look at what we have right in front of us now. This is the Euro USD, and there's something that we always say. We always say, before you start doing something, before you start trading the charts, that you need to do something. You need to pay attention to the news. Check the news. Right, check the calendar, right? Even before checking the calendar, right, make sure that you are aware of your plans. You must also have a plan for each day, right? Don't just wake up, open your charts, and start placing trades. So when you're checking the calendar, which has to do with the fundamentals and the technicals has to do with the charts. Before you go over to the charts, check the fundamentals. And as usual, for those that are new, especially, we did this here. We did like a short process, step-by-step process of how to start trading, right? Where number one, you need to check for upcoming news. I repeat, number one, you need to check for the upcoming news. When is the news coming out? In the morning, afternoon, night, and then also the impact of the news. Is it going to be high impact? Is it going to be medium? How is it going to be exactly, right? So that you can know the volatility, because based on the news, it also has to do with the volatility. So after this news, if you look at what we have next, we said you need to do what? You need to map out your charts, draw your support, draw your resistance levels. After you do that, then you rest, you relax, and then you wait for price, what? You wait for price reaction. That means that price should get there, and then you look at the reaction, right? Please take note of this, guys. I'm talking about this now so that you can write it down, because we're going to cross over to the charts and we're going to merge the two. We're going to merge the fundamentals and technicals together, right? And then you look for your trigger for entry, and then you set your stop loss and take profit appropriately, right? So this is what we do on the regular. This is how we look at the market. So let's cross over now to the upcoming news. Let's check the calendar. And if you have a look at the calendar right in front of us, this calendar is from Forex Factory, forexfactory.com. So from this calendar here, if you look very well, today's date is what? Today's date is Tuesday, February 28th. Happy last day of February. Tomorrow will be a new month, so happy new month in advance. So as you can see, today is Tuesday, February 28th, and the high impact news, because we already did a filter, to show only the high impact news. So the high impact news that we have today is coming out 2:30 p.m. Nigerian time and then 4 p.m. Nigerian time. That is about 18 minutes from now for this first news card. All of them, as you can see, red, they're all high impact news. So we have the GDP, right? We have the GDP coming out for the card, and we are expecting high volatility, fresh volatility in the market for card pairs. That means that where you have the USD card, you have the card JPY, you have the Euro card, you have the Pounds card, and so on. Expect volatility across the board for them. So that means that if you are planning on placing any trade now, I would more or less tell you to be cautious, because if it's going to go against you, it's going to go against you very, very fast and hard. But just make sure your stop loss is in place and make sure that you are using proper risk management. Also, make sure if you don't know where to set your stop loss properly, and also especially you do not know how to calculate your risk, because risk is very, very important. You do not know how to calculate your risk, which is your risk management based on your lot size volume, kindly attend the beginner's webinar, the beginner's masterclass that will be occurring later today, right, by 6 p.m. I repeat, by 6 p.m. If you guys need me to drop the link here, let me know and I'll drop the link for you so that you can save it and then attend it for 6 p.m. Right? So as we're saying, the first one is coming out by 2:30 p.m. So then you need to be aware that card would be explosive, could be explosive rather. And then for 4 p.m., USD could also be explosive. So this is, first of all, a heads up, because a lot of traders are losing a lot of money or even crashing their accounts during news period, right? They are crashing their accounts during news period. Okay, Triumph, please drop the link for the beginner's webinar. Thanks. Okay. As we're talking now, I'm going to go and fetch the link and then I'll drop it here for everybody, right? So as we just said now, traders tend to crash their accounts on a regular, which is not a good thing as well, right? So you need to know the instances, you need to know the times that these things could happen, right? Because once you know, you can start to avoid them, because avoidance is very important. Once you can start to avoid unnecessary losses, right, once you can start to avoid unnecessary losses, it will help you to keep your money. Yes, indeed. It will help you to keep your money, right? Help you to keep your money. And most traders are not having privilege of keeping their money, they're losing a whole lot, right? So just a second, I'm just trying to drop the link here for you guys for day two, just a gentle reminder. So I had to go grab it. Okay, let me just type this out now, just a quick second. Okay, yeah, so I just typed it out for those that requested for it. So that's the information there. You can also share it with people right before the time. You see how about approximately 4 p.m., right? So now this is the news that we've talked about. But from the news, now be aware, 2:30 p.m. and 4 p.m. CAD and USD are what we should be focusing on. Let's cross over to the charts now. Let's go back to the chat and let's walk our way from there. Okay, now looking at the chart of what we have in front of us, this is Euro USD. Don't forget, for the news that we looked at now, we looked at CAD and USD. USD is for 4 p.m., which is roughly 2 hours from now. But if you look at what's happening, we have already checked the news, number one. Now we have mapped out this chart based on support and resistance. If you look at the chart very well, you have here as a form of support, you have here as resistance. And if you look very well, it keeps on acting as that support here. But then when it broke out, it acted as resistance. So this is how to be looking at the market. Now I'm going to fast forward to the major area of interest now, which is this here. This is where price is. If you look at where the price is now, this is where the price is currently, as you can see. But then look at the left-hand side. This here acted as support. You can see price went up. And then this here acted as resistance, 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 and then resistance. What does this mean? This should already give us the heads up that this area here should, right? It should. You can see I'm not saying it would. We're saying it should. That means that there's more or less a high probability of it happening. So this here should occur and it should give us that sell and then drop back down even to these lows over here. This is what we'd like to see, right? But you need to also remember that we have high impact news coming out for the dollar soon enough, right? And that is within the next 2 hours approximately. That's like 1 hour, 44 minutes thereabout, based on the time that we have right now. So this is how you're going to be doing. And you can see this is live. This is live. This is how I look at my chart. This is how I trade. And of course, you are learning firsthand how to do it. So if you can duplicate this, good for you. And of course, if you need further assistance, just let us know. So now the question is, right, apart from the fact that the trend is also a downtrend, you can see the market is a downtrend and you want to sell here at an area of resistance. But apart from this, why haven't we pulled the trigger? Why haven't we jumped into this trade now? We haven't jumped into this trade now simply because we don't have a trigger, right? Whenever price gets to that area of interest where you want to jump into the market, it doesn't mean that you should jump in blindly. Because a question that you might even be asking is, how do I know that that area is going to hold? How do I know that that area is going to hold? How do I know the area is not going to hold? And so on. Is number one, based on the reaction and the trigger. The trigger is what we call the price action candles, right? The price action candles, the PA candles, right? You can see all these here are candles here. So there are some specific candles that we normally like to look out for, that when you have it at that area, then please be my guest and pull the trigger. Pull the trigger, but then ensure that your stop loss is in place, because it doesn't mean that 100% it is going to be a winner. And with that said, a quick disclaimer for you. Kindly note that the information we're giving you, right, based on the fact that this business is a leverage business, the market is leveraged, and it means that you can lose a lot of money and you can make a lot of money. Kindly ensure that you have stop loss in place, number one, and then also ensure that your risk management is well calculated, right? Your risk management should be based on your account balance, right? So that's why I said earlier, if you are still new to this trading business, then you can attend the beginner's training, and we have dropped the link. Please also, guys, we've dropped the link also for this webinar that is happening right now. Do well to put this up on your WhatsApp status, put this up on your groups, on your Telegram, Facebook, Instagram. Let's have more people join us, We're still at number nine. We have nine people here, including myself, right? So we need more people to join us. Can you do that for us? And then, of course, we will help everybody out with what we're doing here today. So this is the Euro USD. So, of course, I'm not going to rush to pull a sell position. If not, I would have quickly gone to my new order and then picked my volume based on my account balance and then clicked on sell. But I'm not going to do that, right? Simply because I don't have that trigger. Now, some of you might be saying, what do I mean by the price action candlestick trigger? I'm going to show you now. We're going to cross back to the slides and show you the trigger that we're talking about based on the candles. So if you look now, right, if you look now at the next slide, these are all key, very important candlestick patterns. These are very key, important candlestick patterns. And out of all of these ones here, we have about 10 here. Out of all of these 10, the four most important ones are these ones, right? So you can see we have even reduced them the more. So I want you guys to do something. Sorry, let me switch back to this one, just in case you're trying to do a screenshot, but I can quickly do your screenshot of this, because of obviously you can start drawing this now and then writing the names, bullish engulfing, bearish engulfing, parami, dark cloud cover, and the rest of them, right? So looking at these candles that we have in front of us, or these candlestick patterns for trigger, right? Because they're all patterns. This one is two, this one is one, this one is one, this one is one. They all have a meaning at the end of the day. They're trying to tell us something, right? They're trying to help us to know what price wants to do next. And that's why, based on these four, you look at the four that we have in front of us. For this bearish pin, this pin is called a pin bar, pin, PIN. You can see it looks like a pin, not like a needle, looks like a pin. It's also known as a hammer. You can also call it a hammer. You can see this bullish pin, it now looks more like a hammer. You can see this body, this here, this green part is the body. You can see this body is bigger compared to this one. So you could either call it the pin bar or the hammer. And then we have the engulfings for bullish or for bearish. When you hear bearish, bearish means down, means that it's time to sell. If you hear bearish trend, it simply means that the trend is down. And if you hear bullish, bullish is what? Bullish is up. So we have the bearish and the bullish. Guys, I hope you've taken a screenshot of this, because I'm going to go back to the charts now, right, so that we don't take much of our day. On my radar, right, because obviously I am a trader, so on my radar, I have a handful of instruments that I'm watching today, right? So we can as well do that as well. Take note of what I'm watching, what we're watching, and watch them together, and hopefully take advantage and make some pips. Pips is equals to money at the end of the day. You can see this one that we talked about now, Euro USD. Nothing is here. I'm waiting. We're waiting. Let's see what comes out of this. Now, the next one, GBP JPY. I love trading. I just needed to say that. I love trading because when I see charts like this, it just brings me so much joy, right? Now, looking at what we have in front of us, right? You can see the first thing that jumps at me is the trend. The market is going up and up and up. So this is an uptrend. As an uptrend, clearly it tells us that the buyers are in control, and it is advisable that you also become a buyer, right? I repeat, it is advisable that you become a buyer as well. So where do you want to buy? You want to buy at the area of support, this area here. So we are waiting, waiting. That's the thing, waiting. A lot of traders do not have that patience. So we're waiting for price to come back here, and then we wait for the trigger to buy and then take it back up. So this might not even happen today. Funny enough, this might not happen today. It might be till tomorrow. It might be till Thursday. It might be till Friday. It might even be till next week. But we have mapped out our chart, and all we have to do is wait. All we have to do, I repeat, is wait. If you notice something, like if you take it back from this point here, this is that price went back to this point here of support, right? It acted a bit, but it did not get back to this area here of resistance. But instead, it went back to this support here. It went further down to the support here, and then this launched all the way. So if you had taken an initial entry over here, and let's say this did not go according to plan for you, and you took it at the next support, look at how much profit you'd have made, and you are still making as a buyer. but then you are waiting for price to come back here. This is another support. So it's all about understanding what you have in front of you and then mapping out your charts, as we said earlier, map out your chart and then wait for price to action. So we're waiting, and the wait might not even be today. And that's what we do as traders. So please, while waiting, do not stare at your chart, but be checking at intervals. Go come back and check at intervals. The time frame we're using here, as you can see, is 1 hour. This is GBP, JPY, 1 hour. And there's a question from Mr. Okwemi Abdulrazak. He said, please, boss, those candles, which time frame are we to consider them? You can consider them on any time frame, right? You can consider them on any time frame. But what I would advise you, please do not, please, guys, I hope you can hear me. This is a very important one. What I would advise you based on the time frame is do not drop to the lower time frames of the 1 minute, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, especially those three. They could easily be a bit too fast. I repeat, those time frames could easily be a bit fast. And I believe most of us are either new traders or we are struggling traders. I repeat, most of us are either new traders or struggling traders. So do not rush to go to the lower time frames yet. But this works on all time frames, and you can do your findings. You can just go to time frames and then check for yourself. So this is the pound JPY, right? If you remember, we have news for CAD, and the news for CAD is coming out in 4 minutes from now. So this is what I will do. Let me just quickly do this together because I don't have anything on radar for any CAD pair, but let's look at CAD together. If you look very well, this is CAD in front of us. And if I'm going to quickly draw levels like support and resistance levels, this is what I will do. I'll put something around here, right? As I can see, some area of resistance, support here and all. Right? If I were to do another one, I could do something around here as well. I can see something here. You can use horizontal lines, or you can use rectangles to map out the area. If you're going to map out the area, remember it is an area, right? Or level or zone. So using this covers a wider, range, just to show you that it doesn't mean our price is going to get to this horizontal line exactly to the T. No, it will get to the area. So for the news coming out in about 3 minutes now, we're going to do something now. We're going to stay on this USD card for the next 3 minutes because based on the news, the fundamentals, right? We can also cross over to the chart, but based on the fundamentals, maybe this is what we would like to see. We'd like to see price quickly drop to this area here and then do what? Push higher. The only thing that I believe would happen, because you can see these highs over here, is an area of profits, an area of resistance. The only thing I can say that most likely will happen, that if this should occur in front of us, right, it most likely will not give us a trigger. Those candles that we have most likely will not find it. It might be one big candle that just drops and then the next one starts to push it higher, right? After you've watched a particular movie over and over and over again, you start to have the sense of what most likely might happen. So let's pay attention to this. That is an option of what could happen based on our markings, based on the trend, which is up. The price could also tear this area and just, when I say tear, it could just drop and tear it. It could even go to the lower one. Or from here, it could just push higher without even coming back to this area, right? So either way, it's always good for you to have an understanding of what might happen. We have about 40 seconds left for the news for CAD to come out. And one thing I normally do myself personally, I will be checking the calendar. And from checking the calendar, you can see by 2:30, we have to refresh it. So if I refresh it now, it's a refresh, but it won't give us anything. It's giving us this green because it is almost time, right? So we're going to do something now. I'm going to just be clicking on this till it's about 2:30 thereabout. We have just a few seconds to go, right? So I'll just be clicking on this green until it gives us the figures. Now you can see that this is very, very live. You can see I'm clicking it back to back in anticipation that 2:30 drops and then we have the news. 2:30 has dropped. Let's see whether we have numbers now. We might need to click on this again. But don't forget, we're expecting volatility. In as much as it's not dropping, let's do something quickly. Let's quickly drop. Let's quickly switch. I said drop. Let's quickly switch back to the chart and let's see what we're having. You can see the early reaction over here, but we need to know what the fundamentals is giving us as well, right? So this is how to trade, combining the fundamentals and technicals together. I just say let's just look at this based on what is happening now. Okay, let's refresh this again. Let's refresh it. We should have numbers. Okay, now the numbers are what? The numbers are negative, red, and that means that we should be selling CAD. So that means that for the USD CAD, we should be buying. We should be clicking on buy for the USD CAD. And that's why it is going up, right? As it is going up from here. As it is going up, okay, sorry, I can see we missed a level here. I can see we missed some things here. Can you see? This is an area of interest as well. Here is what we call resistance. So if we quickly draw this, I'm just saying this here, quickly draw this here, sorry, adjust this a bit. Let me just lower this a bit. If you see this here, you can see what we have like resistance. And this is where the price is over here. So this one that we drew is still valid, where we said it might drop down before pushing higher. This one could also push higher as well. But one thing I could tell you is that we don't have a trigger. So don't rush to jump into the market. You can test it yourself and place trades without trigger and see whether it works for you or not. But I personally, I like to wait for triggers. That means that a lot of times, the market will do according to my analysis, but without me. And then I do not fret, I do not do anything. I accept it because that is part of trading. That is part of the business, right? So, excuse me. So based on what we just said now, this is the USD CAD for you. You can also check on it on your chart. I want us to continue to look at other charts that we have in front of us as well. Like this one, gold. I'm going to show you something on gold. If you look at gold, right, you can see that we don't have anything drawn on it, no markings whatsoever. But on this gold, you know, easily you can see that it's a downtrend. So if you are a trend trader, I repeat, if you are a trend trader, that is, then you would want to sell because the trend is down. Simple. You would want to sell because the trend is down. But if you are a counter trend trader, then you'll be looking for opportunities to go against. That's what counter is against, which is buying. And if you look very well, let me just do these markings here. If you look very well, this area here looks pretty much like what? It looks like a support. You can see that the price has been sitting on this area here, support, support, and then support. Now look at this candle, guys. If you look at this candle, right? Please don't forget our disclaimer. This is not a direct buy now, sell now. I'm just explaining, we're explaining to you so that you have a better understanding. Let me say the disclaimer again for those that are just coming. This business carries a high level of risk. It's a leveraged business, so you can easily lose funds. You can easily make money as well. So in order for you to protect your account accordingly, always ensure that you have your stop loss in place and always ensure that your risk management is well calculated based on your volume, based on your lot size. So for you to do that, if you are not conversant with that, then I would advise you to attend the beginner's workshop, the beginner's class that will be continuing. Yesterday was day one. Today will be day two by 6 p.m. By 6 p.m. And Mr. Toby Okunaga will be handling that. So I have dropped the link if anybody's just joining, right? And you can't see that on the, but I don't think you can see past messages. Just comment and I'll redrop it again, right? So now, if you want to go against the market, then this is what you're going to be doing here. You're going to be looking forward to buying here based on this candle. Look at this candle. Doesn't this look like the pin, right? This candle, you can pinch your screen and increase it, right? This looks like a pin, the pin bar, the hammer, which is signaling further up moves, right? That is what the idea of that candle is, right? But then don't forget you're going against the trend. Now, if you want to go with the trend, this is where you'll be looking out for trading with the trend. You can see here was like a formal support. We have support here. This acted as resistance. That means that you're waiting for the price to come back to this point here, and then you have your trigger, and then you sell, take it back down, and maybe it could even break and continue the trend to the downside. You need to understand, it's a thing of need, and that's why I have to stress the need. You need to understand what you have in front of you, how to map out your chart, how to trade with respect to whether with the trend or against the trend. For me, I am a trend trader, right? Trend trading is safer. You know, they say that the trend is your friend, right? There's a statement that goes, the trend is your friend. Truly, truly, the trend is your friend. And this is a massive, when I say massive, this is a massive downtrend that we have over here. So the favor should be for the sellers. And then don't forget, we have news. This is gold XAU USD. And don't forget, we have news coming out. I believe that's the consumer confidence that we just checked on for the USD by 4 p.m., right? So pay attention to that because anything could happen in this area. But let me clean this up as well and then look at some other instruments. If you have any question, let us know. Makwemi said, what are fake breakout situations? Fake breakouts could easily occur. But the truth now is that when the break occurs, right, then you need to wait. Let the candles close properly. If you don't close properly and then you jump in, then you are jumping into like a fake breakout, right? And that's the market for you. And that has to do with patience. You need to exercise the highest patience when price has gotten to your area. If price is breaking out, right? Exercise proper patience because these things, they do occur. And that's why we said it's an area. Remember, we said something earlier that it's an area, right? Let me show you guys something. Let me just map this area here, something around here. Yeah, just something around here. Just from my eyes, you can see we have like a support here, resistance, resistance, and then resistance and all, right? More resistance here. You can see this area level worked nicely, and then it dropped down all the way eventually. So look at this over here. I'm going to just show you this. Let me just box this area over here. If you look over here, you can see that we had like a sort of breach. So maybe this was like a little fake out to the upside, a little break to the upside. Because you remember we said we're using a rectangle. Someone else could use like a just a horizontal line here. If you use a horizontal line here, like what we have here, you notice that it did what? It actually breached above the horizontal line, and this could easily be like a fake out for some. That's why we say, let the candles close, and when they close, you might now have something that could even trigger you to do or to pull the trigger to take it back down. I hope you understand what I'm saying. I mean, fake outs, also known as false breaks, they occur in the market. But when you see a break, when you see a break, you need to wait for what? You need to wait for the follow-up because it might not be a break. Actually, it might be price still working in that area. It's all an area, not a point. That's one thing we want you to understand. That's why you would always hear the likes of supply and demand zones. Supply and demand zones. Have you ever heard supply and demand point, price point? No. Have you ever heard support and resistance price point? No. It is support and resistance level, support and resistance area, support and resistance zones, right? So take note of that, Mr. Okwemi, that asked the question. So for some other instruments on the radar, here's another one, Euro AUD. Now for this one, I don't need to draw. We don't need to draw our levels. You should be able to identify those areas of interest. Now this is called like a node chart, NUDE, a node chart, because you do not have anything on it. You don't have any indicator. You don't have any tools, you don't have any lines, you don't have anything on it. But looking at this chart, this is a clean one, and these are the kind of charts that we like to see, right? Because they're easy on the eyes. They're easy on the eyes. So once you see this one, automatically you should know, oh, the buyers are in control. It is an uptrend. So what do I want to do? I want to buy. Where do I want to buy? I want to buy at the support. What am I looking for at the support? I'm looking for that price action candlestick trigger for me to enter, and then I set my stop loss, set my take profit, ensure that my risk management is well calculated. That's another disclaimer. Again, I'll be giving out that disclaimer from time to time. So if you pay attention, you'll catch it. Ensure that your risk management is well calculated, your volume, your lot size are good to go, right? And then place the trade and accept the outcome at the end of the day. Accept the outcome because the truth now is that it could be a winner. Good, it worked out based on your plan, based on your your rules, your guideline, and it could be a loss. If it's a loss, it is still good because you follow your rules. Do not doubt yourself. There is no strategy that is 100%. I repeat, there is no strategy that is 100%. And then also, no matter the strategy you are using, you are still going to have losses, and it is not a curse. I have not placed any trade this week because I am in the wait mode. I'm waiting for price to come out to these areas that I am hoping to jump in on a buy or sell based on the trend, based on the chart, based on a whole lot of other things, based on the news, right? We should be combining everything at the end of the day. It's like saying you want to prepare jollof rice. I don't know whether you guys have ever cooked jollof rice before, or worst case, you have eaten jollof rice. What are the things that are going to jollof rice? Apart from the pepper, you have the onions, you have the tomatoes, you have the curry, you have the Maggi, you have the thyme, you have a whole lot of things that go into bringing out that jollof rice for it to be so nice and sweet at the end of the day. Okay, somebody's asking another question. Can you mark the places we can buy on the chat, sir? Okay, no problem. We'll quickly do that for you. Right, we'll do that for you on this Euro add AUD H1. So maybe when we do that, you can what's the name? You can watch it from your end. I was actually about to go and check on the USD card, see what's happening on the USD card. Okay, USD card is still there, but we don't have that firepower. At times it happens, right? For this one USD card, you don't have firepower. It might be waiting on the USD factor as well, right? You know, we have USD coming up by 4 p.m. So at times I could go and look for another one that has to do with card, maybe AUD card. I drag it in. I don't trade AUD card. So please, guys, as we're looking at this, we're looking at this together for the first time. This AUD card, I can see what we have over here. AUD card 2, was it? Nice downtrend, easy on the eyes. What do you want to do? Preferably, you want to sell. So when you look at charts, let some things be instilled in you, right? And then you start to understand much, much better. So quickly now, let's just do some markings here. Let's do some quick markings here. For those that asked, I'm just gonna rush this something in this manner, right? Just do some quick markings here, something in this manner and all. And then we could have, oops, sorry, we could have price come back here, push higher. You could even come back here, push higher, whatever the case might be. So what we're going to do is simply wait to see what price wants to do. Yes, we're going to wait to see what price wants to do. This is another area here. If you look, that's resistance. So we have drawn this here, support resistance, and then you simply wait for price to do its thing. And you can see we have drawn this quickly. You can also draw it. You need more classes. You need more assistance on how to draw this, how to identify price action, areas of interest, support, resistance, supply, demand, whatever the case might be. Let us know. Towards the end, I'm going to be mentioning some offers that we have for you that if you are interested, you can take advantage of. So you can remind me, I'll mention some offers that 10 trade we have for you, so you can take advantage of, and then also how to contact us. If you don't have any account with us, let us know as well. If you don't have an account with us, you can reach out to your account. Sorry, you can reach out to the person that sent you the link to join us. Person will help you to get registered. So you have an account with 10 trade, and then you can start trading. Download the MT5, the MetaTrader 5, and then of course start with a demo or fund your account. You can fund your account with any amount, maybe $100 or whatever the case might be. Right, if you fund with a minimum of $100, I'll tell you how you can take advantage of a particular offer that we have under the 10 trade roof, and I'll give you more offers as we continue. Okay, I have a comment here. Sorry, okay, sorry, okay. Afolabi Adeniyi said thank you, sir. Okay, great, thank you too. So, guys, keep your questions coming in. If you have a particular instrument you want us to look at, we can look at it together. You can see we have been looking at the currencies, we have been looking a lot at the Euro USD, the Euro odd, gold. Gold is not a currency pair as such. It is a metal, a commodity, right? So if you have anything you want us to look at, whether it's equities or whatever the case might be, let us know. So you want us to have a look at whether it's Bitcoin, We usually know that we have Bitcoin crypto traders here and there. Whatever it is, let us know, and then we can look at it together. So now I'm cleaning this. Hopefully, you've taken a screenshot or whatever the case might be. Taking a screenshot, and then let's continue. AUD/USD. That's the AUD/USD. The markings are already there. Nice, clean, clear, simple for us. All you have to do is to wait. I'll tell you something. I don't know that you agree what I'm about to say. Those that have losses, the most losses, or those that have crashed accounts, maybe back to back, those are those people that majorly they lack patience, right? I don't know whether you would agree with that. Those are the people that lack patience. Maybe you could even tell us, maybe you could even list out, maybe just type out the issues that you feel you are having. I repeat, the issues that you feel you are having, and maybe we could quickly address them for you. Don't forget the offers that we mentioned. We'll give you the offers, and then we'll also tell you how you can connect to the offers. And then if you want, I could drop my contact towards the end. So let me know as well. Drop my contact so that maybe if you have a question later or you need direction, we'll always direct you, or you don't know your account manager, or you want to make funding into your account, let us know, and then we would help you out at the end of the day. Okay, I can see somebody, and if Joshua said Euro CHF. Okay, let's quickly look at the Euro CHF. Euro CHF, let's look for the Euro CHF, which is somewhere here. Okay, this is Euro CHF. I'm going to click on it and drag it inside. I don't trade Euro CHF, right? So as I release my finger, it's going to give us the information of Euro CHF. So I personally will be seeing it for the first time with you. Let me move my hand back to this point, and I'll quickly say something, right? Now, as long as you know how to drive maybe like a manual transmission car, whatever the case might be, you should be able to drive any car. You can easily drive an automatic. You can easily drive a Mazda, a Mercedes. You can easily drive a Ferrari, a Range Rover. You can drive a Volkswagen, whatever, right? So that means that the foundation is very, very important. And that's why I said, if you know how to drive a manual transmission vehicle, because there are people that know how to drive the automatic but don't know how to drive the manual. So by saying that means that if you understand price action support and resistance, right, the basic one, price action support and resistance, trust me, you can what? You can trade any instrument of your choice. That's why I said Euro CHF, I'm seeing it for the first time. I'm going to be seeing it for the first time. So I've dragged this back in. You can see the mouse where it is. I'm going to release my hand now. You can see it even told us wait. It's giving us information. So this is what we have over here. This one, first thing that jumps at me is the direction up, but it is not the cleanest. I'll repeat that it's not the cleanest. I can see something around here. I can see some highs over here. So of course, we use highs and lows to map out your levels. I can see another one here. And because it's more or less an up movement, uptrend, you can see it's even coming down already. That means that our like price to get back to this point here for me to buy, or to get back here for me to buy as well. This is Euro CHF live and direct. This is a live trading session with 10 trade, right? So guys, please, the numbers increase and we'll round it up within the next 10 minutes or so. But notwithstanding, always do well to share the link with others that you feel will be able to benefit from this. Remember, it's always good. Sharing is caring. Sharing is caring. I'm smiling because that's what I normally tell my kids. Sharing is caring. So let's share the information with others. Let's share anything and everything with others as well. And also, we asked a question. Maybe we didn't hear. I'm going to ask the question again. All right. How do you guys think that Tentrade can help you out? How do you think Tentrade can help you out to achieve what you have come to achieve? We want to believe that we have all set a goal. We have set a target for ourselves, maybe in this business or maybe in life, for this year, 2023. The second month is already over, which is today. We are going to be going over to the third month. It's just like December. We can still remember what happened December 2022. Before you know it, December 2023 will be around the corner. And then we might not have achieved what we wanted to achieve. So let us know how Tentrade can help you, especially with respect to the business of trading the financial markets. Okay. Afolabi Adeniyi says, sir, when it comes to support and resistance, which of the pairs works more better? Support and resistance works on all instruments. It works on all instruments. You can see I have been thrown like one or two instruments. We have looked at them together, and you can see support and resistance works on them. It also works on any time frame. Whatever the time frame is, whether the lower time frames, higher time frames, support and resistance works on all of them. So it's not necessarily a case of it works better on this, it works better on that. Because if there was a situation, listen to this carefully, because you have hundreds of instruments based on the currency pairs, based on commodities. Commodities are the likes of sugar, cotton, charcoal, and the rest, or based on cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, Litecoin, Ethereum, just name them, right? Equities as well, Tesla and the rest. Now, based on all of these instruments, right? Support and resistance works on all of them easily, right? Trust me, try that out for yourself and see. And it works on different time frames as well. But based on the type of trader that you are, whether you're a scalper, intraday, swing, or position trader, it works on all of them, right? So that is for you to test. Obviously, this is a live trading session. So for me, it is for us to look for opportunities, just like this Euro CHF. I don't trade it. The person that mentioned this would most likely be the one to check on what happens to this after, right? And you can also drop this in the Telegram group. We have a Telegram group as well. And then on the Telegram group, you can drop your chat, and then maybe with time parameter, because for the facilitators, we tend to be in one session or the other, or we could be handling one-on-one or whatever the case might be. Okay, so I have something lengthy here. Let me read it because of time. We're going to be wrapping up sooner than later. Let me also clean this up as well. I think USD JPY is also here. You can see nice and clean up and so on. But let me quickly read this from Okwemi Abdulrazak. He said, I think 10 trick can help us. Guys, you too can also comment. Guys, comment with your own observations or your own how you feel 10 trick can help you out. So Okwemi said, I think 10 trick can help us out by creating a challenge for us, like giving us some task to do, and the results should be uploaded on a particular Telegram page so as to challenge ourselves as well. My opinion. I like your opinion. And what I will say to that, first of all, do you guys like his opinion? You guys can also chip in, right? I need to write that down somewhere as well. I need to write that down somewhere, just a second. I'm going to write it down, take note of it. So I've written it down, and I also need to put that somewhere as well. I'm going to put that somewhere. So, guys, do you like what he just said? Do you like his opinion? If you do, then we can start to think more about it. Right? So the challenge, from what is on my mind, the challenge most likely will be a live trading account. Demo trading, you guys will not you'll not learn fast enough. So I'm thinking for you guys to learn very well, very fast, it has to be a live trading challenge. In this live trading challenge, right, just like Mr. Okwemi mentioned, and you can buttress some more if I'm on the right path with you, Mr. Okwemi, right? For this live trading challenge, it will ginger everybody because it is real accounts. And of course, real accounts, you don't want to lose it, so you do it the proper way. If it's demo, you're not really being tuned. If it's a challenge that, oh, draw your support resistance levels and post it up, people will not be motivated. Trust me, from my experience, I can even tell you for a fact that as we are here together in this free, it is free, in this free live trading session, there's some of us here that our attention is not fully in tune because it is free. Some of us are here, I can't see you, but I want to believe that some of us are here. You're using me to eat, you're using me to do lunch, you're eating now, and then you are here. Some of us are here. I hope you are not driving. Most are here. You are multitasking, doing one thing or the other, and your attention might not fully be here. And that's the truth. And that's why we always say, when you trade live, or when you even pay for something, when you pay for something, you will pay attention. So when you trade live, you would live trade. I don't know that that makes sense, meaning that you'll be serious with it. Okay, and Afolabi Adeniyi said, thank you, sir. Also, I think, nice, I like that. Also, I think with continuous training and materials, of course, we do training back to back every week. We even had one on Sunday, which is an unusual time for us. You can see what Temtrade is doing for everybody. We're trying to give everybody satisfaction, right? Morning sessions, afternoon sessions, evening sessions. That even reminds me, we have a survey, right? We have a survey that you can help us out with. So I'm going to drop the link to the survey. So that you guys can help us fill that, which help us to get more information. You can also chip in these informations over there as well so that we have them, right? You can tell us like you prefer morning session or afternoon session or evening session or weekend session, and then we'll see how we can meet halfway. Don't forget the offers I want to give you. I have a few offers to share with you. If anybody that's interested, you can jump on them and then also give you my contact if you need it. If you don't need it, no problem. You can reach out to the person that sent you the link. You can reach out to your account manager if you have an account with us. And if you don't have, let us know and so on. Okay, I think I was reading what Mr. Falabi said. Thank you, sir. Also, I think with continuous training and materials, with probably a community. Yes, we have a community Telegram whereby we can drop a chat and that might even give us boldness, just like me, that I'm always scared if I'm wrong, if I'm right or wrong. Do not be scared. You want to make money. Scared money, have you heard this before? Scared money will never make money. Your money needs to be what? It needs to be fearless, right? So as your money is fearless, right, it can easily go out and then bring back more money. That's the idea of fearless money. It's like the 300. Can you remember 300? I'm talking about what's most of what the 300. That's the 300 going up against how many? They were fearless. So don't be scared, please. I'm going to drop the link. I'm going to drop the link to the Telegram group so you guys can join the Telegram and can be engaging over there. You have people that would also engage. But guys, I have dropped the survey. Please do well to click on these things. Please fill out the survey for us. Of course, it will be anonymous so that we have the information and see how your thought process is and how we can help you out. It's just about 10 questions, not more than 10. So it won't take you more than 2 minutes to answer. Okay, so let me quickly read them up. So I've answered Afolabi and then my partner said, yes. Okay, yes, live trading account because the spirit of trading demo is different from live account. Exactly. Do we agree with Mr. Okpayemi? I asked that question earlier. Beautiful. I can see that Triumph Chooks. Okay, I think Triumph Chooks should be Triumph Ogochuku. I can see Triumph Chooks has joined us on the Telegram group. Everybody, guys, you can join us on that Telegram group as well, right? So within the next few minutes, as I would wait for your feedback or whatever the case might be, first of all, we hope that you've gotten value from today's session. Please let us know. We hope that you have gotten value from what we have been talking about today. That is number one. And number two, for the offers that we have for you, first of all, please kindly note that we have another Telegram group. The one that we dropped is a general one for like you beginners. Everybody is there, right? Everybody can be there. So we have this one for everybody, and then we have the one that is the Signals group. For the Signals group, for you to join that one, obviously I can't drop the link, but for you to join that one, you need to fund your account with a minimum of $100. Fund your account with a minimum of $100. Talk to your account manager, and then you will be added to that group, right? And then for a one-on-one, if you're interested in a one-on-one 30-minute session with myself, right? Don't forget my name is Tolu Olatunji. Tolu Olatunji, right? If you need a one-on-one 30-minute session with myself, where we'll give you more information like what we've talked about now. We can condense it in 30 minutes and give you like the step-by-step procedure of what to do, how to look at the market, right? It would also give you more information, different things, different area, or anything specific that you want to talk about. Like if you are shy, you can ask questions here. You feel you need a one-on-one, at least you can express yourself better, then no problem for you to join us on that one-on-one 30-minute session. All you have to do is to fund your account with a minimum of $500. a minimum of $500, right? So if you're interested in any of those things that we mentioned, do let us know. We mentioned the Signals group, and then we mentioned the one-on-one 30-minute session. Let me know. You can type in the comment section if you're interested in anyone that we can follow up with you and help you out. There's one thing we always talk about, procrastination. I'm sure we all know procrastination. There's that one thing that we have all said we want to do this year, but we are yet to do it. That is procrastination. And if we're not careful, it might get to the end of the year and we still haven't done that one thing. So you need to kick procrastination out of the door and you need to attack it now. So if you're interested in the Signals group, do the needful now. Excuse me. If you're interested in the one-on-one session, 30 minutes, do the needful now. You can signify so that we can follow up with you, and then you eradicate procrastination because you have given us permission to say, when are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, we'll set up the timing. We'll book a seat for you. That is good timing for you and for us as well, 10 Trade. And we'll do the needful and help you out. Anything that you need, please. Nobody, we're not typing whatever we need. This is past three, right? Anything, and I repeat, anything that you need, let us know. You can reach out to your account manager, reach out to the person that sent you this link. That person could be your partner, your IB, your upline, whatever you want to call it. It's still the same. Reach out to the person, contact your account manager if you need any information, and they will be glad to help you out at the end of the day. So with that said, we're rounding up now. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody. Hope you got value at the end of the day. If you got value, let us know here. Let us know in the Telegram group. You can post up your chat. You can do follow-up. Reach out to your account manager. Let us know what you need. Nobody signal whether you need a Signals Telegram group, $100 funding of your account, or whether you need one-on-one, 30 minutes session with me, $500 to be eligible. And you are funding your account. It is not a payment, right? So you have best of both worlds. You fund your account with that amount, and then you get the information from one-on-one, and then you can trade with it, right? Okay, so the live trading challenge that was mentioned by Mr. Opeyemi Abdulrazak, I will try to discuss that with the management, and then we'll see whether we can set something up for you guys online. Yes, we'll try to set something up for you guys online and then get back to you. Okay, thank you, Mr. Opeyemi Abdulrazak said value. Thank you, Mr. Basi Ayo said value. That means that you guys got value from today's session. Thank you for that. So please do the needful, trade safely, ensure that you are using a stop loss on your chart, and then ensure that you are calculating your risk management appropriately to minimize your losses. Make sure the right volume, the right loss size is in accordance to your account balance. So with that said, for the beginners training, don't forget you can join that. It's happening by 6 p.m. That's 3 hours from now. Mr. Toby Okunuga will be handling that, so you can learn a whole lot. And it will be day two, so do well to attend that session as well. Thank you, guys. I'll be closing this platform now.